people, how are you this morning? It's a beautiful Saturday morning in Nairobi, and I'm heading for a meeting, and I'm late.
Either you yourself and one must come to treat or to seek treatment.
So this is the meeting I'm coming to. It's a Rotary meeting. So today we are doing public image training. So let's get in, guys. Let's go. Let's walk to the conference room. So we are holding it in this place. It's called Desmond Tutu Conference Center. So that's where we are holding our meeting today. It's a tea break. So it's just having some tea.
Now we are having our tea break.
Just taking some tea before we go back for the next session. So yeah, I hope you don't mind the color. It's because of the roof, that's why the video is like that. So yeah, we're So we are done with the first session. I'm going for the next session. So this is the registration desk. We already registered, so we don't need to register again. We're in this conference hall, Jose Jipende Conference Hall. That's what they call it. So yeah. Heading to another one. I've left just before the meeting was over, but they're almost done, so let's go to the next one, guys. Let's keep moving. Wow. So.
On my social media platforms, YouTube, blog, anywhere. And it was a decision that I didn't talk to anyone about it because I was so scared that if I said, I'm just gonna drop everything that I've spent 5 years building, that someone would just be like, are you mad? Are you mental? How can you just abandon it all? But I knew in my heart that I wasn't feeling fulfilled, and I felt like I had a responsibility to be a lot more aware of what it is I was sharing, what my intentions were with that platform, given that I'd built a huge audience. And I said it in the video, it's such a scary thing to be able to speak to an audience of, be it 1,000 people, 100,000 people, 1,000,000, and not be very intentional with what it is your message is. And that's how you start to be shallow and to feed people with very basic things that doesn't really uplift them. And I've always been very aware that I am responsible for the energy that you leave
back to square one. So it's a journey, that's why I'm saying it's a journey to finding your validation, self-worth, and affirmation, because you have to keep going back to the source that makes you feel good about who you are. Now, for me, and even though I said God is my validation, I have to keep going back to my quiet time. I'm a Christian, I'm a born-again Christian. I have to keep going back to my daily devotions. I have to check in with my friends, Mercy, each and every day, because whatever it is I did for that morning keeps me for that day. The next day is another one, it's another battle. You know, it's another attack deal with. It's self-doubt that I have to address. So it's not necessarily false validation. You will not always get it right, But on some days you'll be better, some days it will be bad, it will be ugly, it will be dark. But understanding that it will not be forever, even that darkness and negativity will not be forever. The Bible says joy comes in the morning. So my encouragement to you is, mine is God, yours could be something different, but find it. And when you find it, keep going back to it. Keep drawing from it, because that's what's going to keep you going.
For me, one thing that people actually don't realize about me is, okay, people tell me on social media I'm very bubbly, I'm very happy all the time, but I do spend time working on my happiness and working on my joy. And what I do is actually just lying in my bed. I can lie in my bed for like 2 hours. I'm not sleeping, but I'm thinking and I'm processing my thoughts and spending time with myself. I think one issue, especially when you're in the public eye, is, you know, you just keep going from one project to the next thing, to the next thing, to the next thing. But slowing down to actually reevaluate your life, reevaluate where you are mentally, what's making you happy, what's not, who do you need to talk to. I actually spend a lot of time on my own, working through my thoughts and trying to see where I need to go tomorrow, what do I need to work on. So developing a relationship with yourself. I think somebody here mentioned something about you belong to yourself first and fiercely first to yourself. If I'm not good with myself, I'm not going to share my space, my energy. I'm not going to put anything on the blog. I'm not going to talk to the guy that I'm talking to. I'm not going to talk to Justin. I'm not going to talk to my mom. I'm not going to talk to my dad. You know, I give myself that space to make sure I'm good with myself. And it's a journey, it's a process, and it takes a lot of years. It's things actually that I began to work on since I was 14 because I was mentored and somebody showed me how to work through my thoughts. And it's been 12 years later and I'm still getting through it. So even though we may look like the ones whose lives you look into, I think knowing, as we've said, it's normal, we go through it, work through your journey, but be active about it. Spend time with yourself, get to know yourself, validate yourself, encourage yourself. And it's a daily process. Tomorrow I need to wake up and encourage myself again. When I'm coming for this talk, I have to look at myself in the mirror and be like, today you can do this, you can talk to this crowd. I actually had to do that. I was nervous. I asked my friend Naomi, she met me, she's like, hey, you look a bit nervous. I said, actually I'm a bit nervous. You know, but tomorrow I'm gonna have something else and I have to encourage myself. You know, so taking care of myself, being deliberate, working on it, it's a daily process.
To add to that, I think and I guess it goes, it's in line with what Victoria said. Routine is something that we often underestimate. We see it, I think the world sees it as boring, you do the same thing over and over and over again. But that, if every morning you woke up and you started off with a gratitude list, you started off with a prayer, you started off with great affirmations as to what you want from your day, you started off with thank you notes to the people that matter to you, you started off with exercise, with eating the right thing. Routine is so important because it makes sure that the rest of your day is in line with what exactly your intentions are and what you want to achieve. So have something that brings you joy, whether it's, or peace rather, whether it's prayer, meditation. I listen to a lot of podcasts, ones that are around building your brand, yourself, your body, whatever it may be, trying to be a better mother, a great mother. So whatever it is that makes you happy and brings you joy, if it's texting someone, if you like to speak to someone because you know that they bring you joy, have it very clear in your mind that these things make me feel better about myself, or just, you know, reminding you of who I am and what it is I want to achieve and what my purpose is in this world, and make sure that you go back to those things. But routine is so important. And I think another thing is to be very wary of seeking validation from others, because you never know when that relationship, it could have started off in amazing, but at some point, relationships do get toxic. And if you're still seeking validation from that man, from that boss, whatever it may be, and things are not right, you're never going to get it. And you'll, for the longest time, it's just always going to be a matter of.
So it's a bit dark, we are done with the meeting now. So I'm super excited. I got to meet Sharon, Kevin Yellow, so many guys over here. It was super duper nice. We enjoyed the meeting. I hope they do this often. Make sure guys you subscribe, comment, like, share. Yes, bye.